And the Sringara that Anumacharya composed is by far the most superior kind of Sringara, because at 1408, 1503, that was his time, the Telugu literature was flooded with all kinds of erotism, all kinds of gymnastic literary feats. At that time he restrained himself by writing just divine love, and that too very beautifully, not getting down at any particular point of time to the mundane Sringara at all. And the reason why I say this is a wonderful book, though this book is a kind of a glimpse, because this contains 34 pages, including the contents. But don't judge it by the number of pages, because it is T.S. Parthasarathi and Mani Krishnaswami. Just that one reason is enough to say this is a great book. And this book deals with those aspects that will give us a glimpse into what could have been the kind of music. I'm sure all of you know that these were engraved on copper plates between 1525 and 1545 and were stored inside the temple premises. And all these compositions, and some people ask me sometimes what happened to the rest of the 18,000 compositions. There are 32,000 according to Chinnathirumalacharya, grandson of Hanumacharya. And we have inherited only 14,000. What happened to 18,000? I will say the reason, but I would hesitate to translate into English because of a shame that this particular reason is embedded with. They say, Ragamu teliyani jati ragi kariginchukunnadi. I don't want to go into details about that. But very unfortunately, we have lost those 18,000. But fortunately, whatever 14,000 we have are all published and imprinted 29 volumes by the Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam. And until now, this particular book of Rajanikantra first mentioned 89 ragas as those employed by Annamacharya for the 14,000 songs that we have inherited. TSP for some reason thinks that there are 100 ragas, and I cannot but accept with it. And out of these 100 ragas, there are ragas like Samantam, where he composed in 946 songs in Samantam. And Samantam is one such raga which has not been employed by anybody after him until Muthuswami Dikshit. So the reason why I am saying this is an important book is there are clusters of research here and there scattered all over, done about the pre-Trinity music seen in the southern and south Carnatic music. But there is no proper solid focused music research, particularly because everything is going on a kind of guesswork. It is not exactly pinpointing what could have happened and what could have been the history of Carnatic music before the Trinity and what could have been the shape of music in those days. There are, of course, I don't deny that there have been researches, but all of them are just scattered all over. There is not a particular kind of consolidated work on that. This particular book is a vital, it forms, it constitutes a vital link in the direction. And I'm grateful, I have 5 minutes, I don't want to talk more, but there are people, I have heard very recently, that some people say that Annamacharya could not be classified as a Vagyayakara at all. Well, research is sometimes perversion. And we want to measure the standard of our ancestors with the yardsticks of the present day. Sometimes that is foolishness. Because, you know, people say that, you know, according to Shangadeva, Vacham Gen Chikurti Yasami Gopala Baba, Kati Gatita Mekala Kachita Manigantika Patalinade and Vibhrajamanam. What else do you want apart from this kind of rhythm inherent in that to call a particular composer as a composer? Thank you very much.
It is on the dais, an honored guest. The time given to me is restricted to 5 minutes on the topic that is given is the contributions of Mani Krishna and the devotion
of this.
Before you could embark upon it, one should understand what is devotional music. Is it alien to Carnatic music? Or is it alien to any other system of music in South India as it was prevalent in those days? The term devotional music is a loose term applied to our Carnatic music where bhava is fully embellished. Can anybody give a definition, be a musician or a musicologist, of the difference between a kriti and a kirtana? I had such many books for that, and I'm yet to get a precise definition on the difference between the two. Even Tyagaraja is used both kriti and kirtana in his compositions. In Sagasugamrita Tanamu, he uses the expression as kriti of his composition. In other context, he uses the term kirtana. But, padam. And mainly, as he has very elaborately dealt with, in his Tyagaraja's Devinaman, it's called Devinaman Kirtanam, not Devinaman Kriti. Does it lack in musical grammar? Question is put to us. So devotional music is a loose term that is being used for Sankirtana. But what was in vogue for ages is only Sankirtanam and not Sangeetam. Even Vishnu Purana says, Kalau Sankirtya Kesavam. The expression that is used is only Sankirtanam and not Sangeetam. I don't want to enter into controversy on that because it's a debatable subject. Today, few questions have been posed before you by Pappu Venugopal Rao. It's a good subject for a debate, but this is not the stage in which we can enter into the debates. But two things I have to say. Though he is, Mr. Krishnamurti has jokingly mentioned about Aravam, I say, Bharadasan said, Tamilukku Amudan Chepper. Not that I am against Telugu or the saying, each language has its beauty, it cannot be condemned. That thought should not come out. Secondly, Thirumurur said, Tamil, Vadamuri, Iru Kangalavana. There are two eyes, Tamil and Sanskrit are two eyes. In Vishnu Purana, Vishnu is said as supreme. In Shiva Purana, Shiva is supreme. That doesn't mean that Shiva alone is supreme or Vishnu alone is supreme. All the Vaikaras who have sung in praise of God are supreme, are on equal status. That equanimity amongst composers was brought in by only in Sampradaya Bhajan. What he called Sampradaya Bhajan. Though historians and musicologists like Pappu Venugopal Rao write about the advent of the Kirtanas of Annamacharya to come to public only after 1920s. 300 years ago, the Sadguru Swami had, who travelled from Kanyakumari to Kashmir and collected all the compositions of various saint composers and also collected Annamacharya's compositions too. If it's not prevalent there in Andhra, he would not have collected it. The very first song of Thodai Mangalam, because my guru used to say Thodaka Mangalam, not Thodai Mangalam. The reasons are different, but I don't want to elaborate it because time gives 5 minutes. The Thodaka Mangalam is Annamacharya's compositions incorporated. He is the first person who brought national integration to music. He brought in Sampradaya Bhajan all the compositions of various saint composers right through Himalayas to Kanyakumari. So, Annamacharya's Kirtanas are known but not published. Which was published nearly 3 centuries ago. Absolutely, we don't have any record for it. Because we don't have any history of our music authenticate the history of music. That's why, as he rightly said, Mr. Venugopal Rao, each one has their own assumption and add it to the history of music. I stop with that as an introduction. Mani Krishnaswami came to be very well implicated in Sampradaya Bhajan after she joined Swami Haridas Giri in the year 1975. Musicians do not mistake me. There was an impression amongst musicians, rightly so because they had proper reasons for it, that to participate in a bhajan will be considered as a dilution of Carnatic music. So they did not want to participate in bhajan sampradaya or bhajans. But the picture is totally turned now. Everywhere you see, even today, there is a bhajan program. Reasons are known to you and not elaborated. Mani Krishnaswami got involved herself in this Sankirtana tradition from 1975 onwards, over a period of 19 years, till my Guruji breathed his last or attained Jalasamadhi at Rishikesh. I'm sorry, at Rudrabhaya. So that 19 years or 20 years, I can say, both years inclusive, she was participating in all the bhajan programs, and the fervor with which she used to render kritis of Annamacharya, like the music, it blesses the person, elevates the person who sings and elevates the person who hears. That was her music, that was her association with devotional, divine music, you can call it, because every music is divine. As Meera sang in one song, Bhava Bhakti Ka Bhuka Meera. She sang that, I don't have in my music the Bhava, in Bhakti that Bhava. I am hungry of that. Bhava Bhakti Ka Bhuka Meera, she sang. That way, the music, if it is said to be a music, it's life. It should be a Sankirtana. But Kirtana has more concentration on Bhava of that particular kriti or particular composition. See, that way, Kirtana stands on a different footing of elevating a person, but kriti also does it if it is rendered with Bhava oriented. Because it is restricted to gramam, it is restricted to certain discipline.
என்னுடைய நண்பர்கள் எல்லாம் மேடையில் நிற்கும் நண்பர்கள் ஸ்காலர்ஸ் மூத்தரும் பேசின அந்த அழக பார்த்தா அவ அந்த பாட்டுகள் எல்லாம் ரொம்ப அனுபவிச்சு அந்த அர்த்தத்தை எல்லாம் தெரிஞ்சுக்கிட்டு இந்த பாஷ வேறுபாடே இருக்கக்கூடாது என்ற அபிப்பிராயத்தை ரொம்ப அழகாக சொன்னாங்க. அப்பொழுது எனக்கு என்ன ஒன்று தோன்றிட்டு என்றால், இந்த ப்ராப்ளம் எனக்கு வரவே இல்லை. ஏன்னா ஃபிடில் எடுத்துட்டு
விட்டேன்.
அதனால சொன்ன அத்தனை பாஷையிலே நான் புள்ள வாசிருக்கேன். நம்ம சங்கீத கலாநிதி, சங்கீத கலாநிதி டாக்டர் மணி கிருஷ்ணசுவாமி அவர்கள் போய் 4 வருஷம் ஆயிடுத்து நம்ம விட்டு பிரிந்து, ஆனா அவர்கள் அவருடைய சங்கீதத்தை நண்பர் கிருஷ்ணசுவாமி பப்பு வேணுகோபால் சொன்ன மாதிரி புக்கு மூலமா, ரெக்கார்டு மூலமா, கேசட் மூலமா நிறைய நமக்கு தந்திருக்கிறார்கள். அது மட்டும் இல்லை, ஏராளமான ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸுக்கு சொல்லிக் கொடுத்திருக்கிறார்கள். அதனால அவருடைய சங்கீத அந்த லெகசி இருக்க இட் வில் கண்டினியூ ஃபார் எவர். அவர் முஸ்ரி சுப்பிரமணியர்கிட்ட பாடம் கற்றுக்கொள்கிற காலத்தில் நான் அடிக்கடி முஸ்ரி சுப்பிரமணியம் அதில் பார்த்துருக்கேன். அதாவது மத்தியானம் 2-3 மணிக்கு ஆரம்பிப்பார் முஸ்ரி சுப்பிரமணியர் வாழ்க்கைலாம் சொல்லி கொடுக்கறதுக்கு, கிட்டத்தட்ட ராத்திரி 9 மணி வரை இப்படி உழைச்சி அவர் சொல்லி கொடுத்தத மறக்காம அபியாசம் பண்ணி சாதகம் பண்ணி அப்படி பாடினபோதுதான் நம்ம நாரதன சபா கிருஷ்ணசாமி சொன்ன மாதிரி அந்த பாவத்துடன் அது வெளியில வருது. இது இருந்தா தான் எந்த வித்வானுக்கும் அந்த பாவம் வேணும். எந்த பாட்டுக்காரனா இருந்தாலும் சரி, எந்த வாத்தியக்காரனா இருந்தாலும் சரி, இந்த மாதிரி உழைச்சி அத பக்தியோட பாடணும். நிறைய பணம் வருது நமக்கு, பக்திங்கிற ஒரு அந்த ஆஸ்பெக்ட் இப்போது சங்கீதத்துல கொஞ்சம் குறைஞ்சு போச்சு. அதுக்கு அதை பத்தி அதிகம் இப்பொழுது பேச வேண்டாம், இன்னொரு சந்தர்ப்பம் பேசிக்கிறேன். எனக்கு என்ன இன்னைக்கு திடீர்னு இங்க வந்து கச்சேரி பண்ண சொல்லியிருக்கா. நான் வந்து பிளான் பண்ணிட்டு வரல, ஆனா ஒன்னு ஒண்ணு மட்டும் சொல்லியிருக்கேன். இந்த மணி கிருஷ்ணசுவாமி ஃபவுண்டேஷன் ஒரு ஆரம்பிச்சிருக்கா, அது அதனால மணி கிருஷ்ணசுவாமி சங்கீதத்தை பத்தி எவ்வளவோ பேசலாம், இன்னும் நிறைய சந்தர்ப்பம் இருக்கு பேசுறதுக்கு. ஒரே ஒரு வார்த்தை சொல்லி கொண்டு நான் முடித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். டாக்டர் மணி கிருஷ்ணசுவாமி பார்ன் வித் மியூசிக், லிவ்ட் வித் மியூசிக், லெஃப்ட் தி மியூசிக் ஃபார் ஆல் ஆஃப் அஸ், லெட் ஹர் லெகசி கண்டினியூ அண்ட் பில்ட் தி ஃபவுண்டேஷன் ஆல் சக்சஸ் அண்ட் பி ஆஸ் எ ட்ரஸ்டி. We all seek your assistance and help for the foundation and growth of the foundation, and also for the music, Mani's music to continue forever. Long live Mani Krishnaswami's music. Thank you.
Gentlemen, on behalf of Mrs. Mani Krishnaswami's family and on behalf of my colleagues on the Board of Trustees of the Mrs. Mani Krishnaswami Foundation, I take great pleasure in proposing a word of thanks to everyone who helped make her 4th memorial anniversary a success. I know all of you are keenly waiting for the next program this evening to begin, the melodious and bhakti-laden Rama Sankirtanam of Sri Udayalur Sri Kalyanarama Bhagavat. Everyone who knew my mother will surely recollect that Mrs. Mani Krishnaswami was a very avid lover of Dakshina Sampradaya Bhajana tradition. Fittingly, this evening Sri Kalyanarama Bhagavata's recital will pay homage to her memory. Ladies and gentlemen, I will not take much of your time while performing my pleasant duty in proposing a word of thanks to the following persons. First and foremost, I must say that the trustees of the foundation are deeply indebted to Sri P. V. Krishnamurthy, who readily and willingly agreed to preside over this evening's event, substituting Sri A. P. V. N. Sharma, DPD Executive Officer, who unfortunately could not participate due to unavoidable reasons. Sri PVK Mama has been a family friend of ours for more than 5 decades. No words would be sufficient to thank him for his magnanimous gesture today. I thank you very much, sir. Sri Pappu Venugopal Rao has rendered yeoman service in propagating the works of Annamaya, and it was only fitting that he received the first copy of the published monograph on Annamaya, authored by my mother. The trustees of the foundation are grateful to him for his presence and for his very interesting observations about the monograph. Thank you, sir. One person who deserves special words this evening is Sri T.S. Parthasarathy, music scholar, historian, doyen, and fellow of the Sangeet Natak Academy. His help and guidance to my mother in writing the monograph, in light of her failing health in the last few years of her life, that my mother was able to complete the project and the monograph for the Academy. Our deep and sincere thanks to T.S.P. Mama. It was indeed very kind and gracious of Sri R. Krishnaswami to have been present on this occasion to speak on the subject. Sri T.N. Krishnan, formerly known in our family circles as T.N.K. Mama, has been a family friend and one of the closest and constant companions of my father, Sri N.K., all these years. T.N.K. Mama's presence amidst us as a trustee in the foundation is going to be a great source of support to all of us. Thank you, Mama. Srimati Prema Srinivasan and Srimati Kamala Kasturi were probably two of the closest friends of my mother. Two of the closest friends my mother ever had in life. And that they readily agreed to become trustees of the foundation shows us how much they both cherish the memory of their dear friend, Mrs. Mani Krishnaswami. Thank you very much. Sri P.K. Seshadri, well-known senior advocate of Madras, is a family member and founding trustee of the foundation. We thank him for explaining the purposes and future plans of the foundation. Sri S.P. Prabhakar Rao is another very, very close family friend of ours. He has kindly offered his services to the foundation, and the trustees deeply appreciate his gesture. We thank the PS High School authorities for permitting us to make use of this fine auditorium this evening. We thank the technical team here in charge of the PA system. We thank the members of the press and other media for their presence here this evening and for their coverage of the proceedings of the 4th memorial anniversary of Mrs. Mani Krishnaswami. Our special thanks go to Doordarshan Kendra at Chennai for telecasting yesterday evening a very fine document. Also go to the Shishyas of Mrs. Mani Krishnaswami who rendered a very beautiful and solemn prayer song to begin this evening's proceedings. The trustees of the foundation also wish to acknowledge with thanks those who sent many messages by mail from many parts of the country wishing the event a success. Thanks on a slightly personal note about my father here, Sri N.K. I'm happy to tell you that in a week from now, Sri N.K. will be celebrating his 80th birthday. For family members and friends alike of N.K., it is a joyous occasion. None of us, however, can help the rather sad thought. How much sweeter would the occasion be of N.K.'s 80th birthday had Mrs. Mani Krishnaswami also stood beside him. Alas, that is not to be. For as the English poet Shelley said, we look before and after and pine for what is not. Our sweetest songs are those that tell our saddest talk. For a good part of 80 years, N.K. was a devoted supporter and promoter of Mani Krishnaswami's distinguished music and career. Now, even after her departure from the mortal world, N.K. steadfastly continues to commemorate my mother's immortal music out of his love for her as a person and out of his abiding devotion to the larger cause of Carnatic music and his great Vagyakaras. Ladies and gentlemen, this evening I offer my last vote of thanks to my father for nothing else but just his presence here amidst us. I take this opportunity to request you all to please give the grand old man of 80 a big round of applause. Thank you. We now request all of you to please stay back and enjoy the wonderful Namasam Kirtana which now follows by Sri Udayalu Sri Kalyanaram Bhagavata.
Mama. தோடை மங்கலத்தை கம்போஸ் பண்ணவா மூணு பேரு பத்ராஜ ராமதாசர் ஜெய ஜானகி ரமண ஜெய விபீஷண சரண ஜெய சரோருக சரண ஜெய தீன கருணா. அடுத்தது ஸ்ரீ அன்னவாச்சாரியாருடைய
சரணு சரணு சுரேந்திர சரணு ஸ்ரீ சதி பல்லவா சரணு